But I started actually 6 years ago when I came from Detroit. I went out to teach financial literacy, and I noticed when I got done speaking, the majority of the people that were having the issue were entrepreneurs. So I realized that if you have bad personal finances, then you're going to have bad business finances. So therefore, there's no stability in our business community. So I figured I had to start something that would help to create where we're able to build an infrastructure so we can stay around. So.
How difficult was it to get this thing together from the initial start?
You know what? I love Cleveland for that. Sometimes we spend so much time talking about who doesn't support us that we don't praise the people who do support us. And Cleveland has really been a blessing to me. So in year one, Philly was there. I mean, since the beginning, Josh was there. I mean, we had some people who've been there since the beginning, and literally we had about 600 to 800 people for the first year. We took some trailway buses around the city of Cleveland, like, you know, and we went and we hit black owned businesses right here in our community. People thought I was crazy. Some of the buses were empty too. But we did a glow run downtown, down Superior, landed right on Public Square. We happened to be back home. But that was how we started in the beginning. And then from there, it's grown every year. We've had national names, people who are in the city that are national names. So it's been a blessing, man.
Talk about this particular event. How does it compare to the events in the past? Is this the biggest and best so far?
You know what? The rain kind of hit us, but when we talk about the love of the city, man, what I saw out here was family. Because what happened when it rained, everybody started to share their tents. So people started, you had young kids grabbing tables and saying, no, we don't let you get wet. Come on, under this tent and share it with me. So it showed that we're a family, man. People stayed, they waited. Josh told them don't go nowhere, they ain't go nowhere. So you know what? I mean, it is big, man. So it rain hit us a little, but we're doing, we're blessed.
Let me ask you this. What is the message that you are putting out there today? And you've been putting out for many years.
Yeah, you know what? I happen to stay in the hotel because I come out, anytime I do an event, I pray the night before. I come out, ask God to do what he wants to be done, you know, with anything that he gives me. So I ask for him to give me the vision today so it'd be a blessing to everybody here. But all that being said, I was in my hotel, I'm walking up the stairs, I think I told somebody this earlier, and I had to walk up a staircase. And I realized staircases are made of multiple stairs. And I'm only one step in that staircase to get to the vision and who we need to be operating as a community. So I would say that it doesn't matter if you feel like you're too small or what you're doing. You're still you're one of the steps in that staircase that's going to get our community to that next level. So all I'm going to say to y'all is, I'm one of the stairs. You can be one of the stairs. And we can go as high as we can, as we want to, if we all build our own stairs together. Y'all with me? Y'all hear me?
That's good stuff. Can we bring Andrew Jackson over here?
Gotta bring the man.
He is the man.
Gotta bring the man.
What's up, my friends? See, the thing about Andrew that's incredible is that he's one of Cleveland's own. He's a man who grew up right here in the city, inner city, and doing big, wonderful things right now. As a matter of fact, he's my hero. Andrew, tell us, man, first of all, talk about your humble beginnings, brother, and where you are right now.
I thought I was going to talk about Larice, man.
I want to talk about you right now. Okay. Can we talk about Larice?
Well, I'm from the hood. I tell people I'm from the hood and I made good. I grew up on 119th in Kinsman. I remember riding the 14 bus downtown to work at Society National Bank over here.
Yeah.
And I am proud of what Larice is doing here because it shows that we together can do things, great things together. And right now I own a manufacturing company too, but I'm most proud of the fact that I can employ some people. See, if you have a business, the most important thing is that you're not a business of one or two, but you're a business of 25, 30, 40, 50, and you can hire some people and get people good jobs and benefits so you can feed their family and make sure they make a good living. That's what I'm proud of about being a businessman in Cleveland.
Excellent, man. Excellent. And the key is, if you can do it, they can do it.
Right.
That's the bottom line.
Right.
He is one of Cleveland's shakers and movers.
Can I say one more thing?
Go ahead. Marco,
is that... I know that people, Larice does a lot of stuff in the community and talk to people about running businesses and all that. But you all, there's some young kids out here today who are up on their way and up and coming. We need to teach our young African-American kids how to be business people. That's the number one thing, you all, because we should learn from what we know and make sure they don't go through what we had to go through. And it's very important that we bring the young kids down to this, Larice, so we need to have the young kids appreciated down here today because they're the future of our community. So if we don't do anything else, everybody teach one and reach one and make sure we teach our young kids how to be business people.
Andrew Jackson, let's give him a round of applause. Cleveland.